on this capture. There we go. Take the link from it. Okay, so I think now I'm now we are online. Okay, this is pop up. Vale. Well, ya está. Now we have it. Hello to you all once again. Let's take a look and see an analysis for today, 14 October 2021. Yesterday, although initially it looked like a bearish trend at the beginning of the day, I did say as well that since it's Wednesday in general, you can kind of expect that it's going to go back as a bullish, and today is kind of vice versa. We see it as a bullish for the last hours and half of the day, and I expect it by the end of the day to become a short possibility. But yeah, let's take a look into it. Let's go on the big one. We can take a look after on the dominoes. So well, actually I'm going to make my own. Well, no, this one is good enough. Yeah, so let's go with I'd say 1 hour. Let's go first one more time. Let's go on the 4 hours. So we can see, like I said yesterday, we are approaching the big support and resistance, but the big resistance point, sorry, which is on, of course, it's on 60,000, and we went once, looks like we went for 58, and now slowly it's going down. So yeah, it's very crucial this point. At the same time, if we are looking on the total, we can see the same stop. We can see that we are right here on 2.4, and it's very important to beat this one. While we beat this one, we have another margin of, you can see, like 3-5%, and then of course the biggest one, which is going to be the 2.5. If we are going to break this, I believe it's going to serve as a good catalyst in order to further improve and move, you know, the market towards a bullish direction. Because think about it, many people are going to reach the positions when they initially enter, when it was the ATH, and it's going to serve, it's going to go on top of it as a good opportunity, you know, to continue to enter in the sales, I'm sorry, in the trade, and make more profits. So yeah, we have this one. One more time, let's take a look at BTC dominance. Well, we can see that slowly it's stagnating, and that means that we might start to have again another alt season, you know, because for now it was Bitcoin season, but slowly I believe we'll start to have an alt season as well, if we are going to continue in this direction, of course. So go back to BTC. Yeah, we can see we have no change. We have the entry the beginning of the month, so no change for this long. Let's take a look at the shorter time frame and see how they are performing. We can see the double bottom. We can see on 56. We can see when we broke it, more or less here, and then yeah, we went for the 58, and after 58. It started to decline again. So it's it sounds like a very good point, and I feel that many people are still afraid, you know, of committing and going even further with this. But yeah, we will see in the following days. We'll see in the following. I believe we still have kind of 1 week before it starts to have the correction of the month, and at the same time expiry day for options and so on. When do we have the? When is the Friday this month? The last Friday is going to be on 29th. So yeah, I believe we still have some time. But the market doesn't do always what it wants. You know, we should already know this. Anyway, let's take a look at ATH as well. Yeah, we can see as well, we can see that the 3.6, and we can see that people are afraid to commit even further, and kind of the same situation, you know, with this one. Right now we are in the side market for the last days, you can see for the last week, nothing interesting happening here, so yeah. Let's take a look at the total, one more time, but this time with the 10 minutes time frame. Same time, you can see we're in a side market period, not so many changes. Now looks like we enter again on this bullish. Actually yesterday started 5%, but yeah, slowly. It's very uncertain, you know, those moments that we have right now. But yeah, anyway, let's take a look at other crypto pairs as well that we have here. So in general, if I remember correctly, the change, I don't want to the volume maybe. A moment please. Actually, I don't want this change. I want change percentage. I don't know why you have to be like this. So yeah, let's go on the entire utility market. Then let's see what we have for today. Let's see what interesting. Bell looks like belly exploding since yesterday. No, since actually 2 days ago it went almost 100%. No, I believe it's a little bit late. Bake as well, it went like crazy, 30%. Let's look 1 hour or 2 hours, yeah, much better. So we can see we broke the point of 2.1, and after that, it's another one. Unfi looks like it's there, Dodo is there. Yeah, those points are actually kind of the resistance point, both Dodo and this one. Ref. Yeah, kind of all of them, they are in the same situation. Well, REF, it would be the one that has, CTK, it would be the one that has a bigger margin. So, you would have a 10% and you would have a 7% stop loss. ADA, CRV. This one as well, looks interesting. You would have very nice opportunity here to buy. 8.5, I believe you can go, and you can go 7 better. The 7 Luna as well might be a good opportunity. We would have a 10%, and then this one in a link. It was sleeping, now it's kindly waking up. Okay, so yeah, these are some nice opportunities that came. Oh, yeah, I like this one even more. Okay, we have a 10% stop loss here. Very nice. Mask as well. can go for here, 7% with 20%. We've got rune as well. Can go rune 9% with 20%. So yeah, there are a lot of nice trades actually that we can find here. Let's take a look and see how the bots are doing. You can see that yesterday we entered in another long entry on the Dominus ATH. So far it's going pretty good. Let's take a look at the 1 hour as well, I'm curious. I believe it's this one. And ATH BTC, let's take a look. So yeah, looks like we have an entry. Yeah, it entered a little bit later on the 1 hour. Well, so yeah, not bad. ATH BTC, kind of slow lately, but nice shorts. We have very nice shorts. So yeah, looks like not bad so far. It's going good. We just hit the TP 1 week ago. Then we have a little bit of stagnation, and now again. So yeah, not bad. Let's take a look if there is magnific as well. ATH perp, what is this one? 15 minutes. And 15 minutes, both of them. This one will look better because we have more trades. We have 700 trades compared to 196, so it gives us more. Okay, so let's make this one actually. Magni 5.1. So we want to have, which one it was? It was this one, the first one. So we have close 21, Alma 5, 36. 6.5. Okay, so this is going to be FTX. But I don't like that lately, it's not performing so good. So ATH perp, I don't like this. So I'm looking at these settings, but honestly I don't like them so much. Let's take a look at these other ones. If it would be 15 minutes, maybe we can find better settings. Close 59. Vidya. So Frama 12. Yeah. Oh, this one looks much better. Now we have 20. Sorry, 9.5. 4.7 and so. Damn, this looks pretty good. Yeah, those settings are looking pretty damn good. if I go ATH USDT per, let's see if there is a difference. Well, actually, it looks like it's working better on the ATH perp. So yeah, you can see this one, the entry was on 12 actually, created on 3.4 with 15 minutes. Have a lot of movement here. Yeah, but yeah, it looks pretty damn good, this one. I like it. I'm going to save it here for the future reference. So yeah, we can see that both MACD and Dominus are doing a great job with the automated products. So yeah, now in terms of trades that somebody can do manually for today, I told you, you can take a look into these ones. And you can have, for example, that's not the wrong thing. One moment. So yeah, like I said, let's go. I think 1 hour should be enough. Let's give some, well, look for example this one. If you want Dodo, a fast entry, and you feel afraid, you can go 1.5 with the ATH. So for Dodo, I think it was Alt H. You can have something like this. In this case, I believe it's going to go to the ATH. Not highest ATH, but it can go to the ATH. You can have, for example, some nice entry here. Then let's take a look at another ones. What else do we have? Look, for example, this one as well. We can have the ATH. We can use it on the 11. Well, 11.5 as well can say. You know, so 11.5, and if you want to use the take profit, I believe it should be something like this. For the own fee, CTK looks pretty good. We can go with 2.2, or maybe this one, 2.136. And here I will put a stop loss. ATA as well, ATA. I believe it can go here and stop loss below the highest candle. So we can see in general we have a lot of opportunities that can go with the risk reward, you know, 2 or 3 for 1, you know, so you lose 1 but you gain 2 or 3. What else can we have? But not so much. This one can go even higher, so we can go for this place more or less something like this. So you can use this in this case, it would be 1-to-1. Luna is a good one. Stop loss somewhere around here, I believe you can go for the take profit. Yeah, because we take it from this place as well. It look like you see a double bottom forming out here and going out. So that kind of should do the trick as well. Link, like I said, link it enter, but oh, long gala on stop loss. You can go even here, you can go here, even here. You can have multiple levels for this one, you know, for going on near 1. Yeah, as well, believe 1.9, well, let's go 1.89, and we can go somewhere around here. It could be for the audio, then even higher, get both of them like that. Then not so much, This one is a little bit late. Acro late. This one is good. Mask. Stop loss. If you want 10, 4.11 as well. You can go. So you can have two of them. Same stuff. No. Please. Same stuff. Very nice movements. So yeah, for now I'm going to keep those as a. I think it's more than enough as a reference that we have. And tomorrow we will see. Let's take Shiba. Shiba not so much. 1 exact, 1 inch. Ava maybe as well. But looks like this side market the entire month. Also not a great to spare. This one it's interesting. Oh no, please we have Inker. Audio upon Bake as well, by the looks of it, all of it, when did it start? It started. It's 1 day and a half. Might be late though. Might be late, so. You know. Off. This one exploded. BNB looks like it wants to go for 500. Going to continue in this direction. This one can be as well. Something like this. And like this. Oh, this one looks calm. Calm looks pretty nice. One. Two. Three. Home looks pretty damn nice. Because it's been pretty fucked up by the news. But it had some nice opportunities. But this is using 1 hour. Maybe in the future I'm going to make analysis using a shorter time frame. You know. We will see. Like I said, slowly I'm going to get back on the stream. I'm getting bad with the stream and I'll try to see how I can make it much more suitable and profitable for all of you. FLM as well. And go here with the safer option. FTM not Gala, we did it. This one BTC, I already did it. Bar HD hot ECP as well, even though I fucking hate it, but yeah, if you want to be safe you can go for this. Maybe on this 55. Oh, this one looks pretty good. Oh, fuck. Not not the best risk reward there, but yeah. This one of all, so clean. So clean. This one as well. One, 1, 7. SVP went like crazy the other day, looks like. Yeah. We can expect a short here as well then. Know how much we have from here. 20%, 28%. And it can go for what? 2.5 to 1 to 1. You can have a 1 to 1 short if you want for that one. Oh, here as well. So yeah, I believe all of those are long trades because of how the market is moving right now. The bottom line, like for example, let's take this one or how it was, hello, Acro Alice. So the bottom one, it would represent the stop loss, top ones, it would represent different take profits. Tomorrow, let's see, you know, how they perform. Let's take a look into it. However, I did it more on the fly, you know, and yeah. Thinking, you know, to use maybe a better shorter time frame, you know, for daily updates, like 15 minutes. I think it can do, it can work much better. Well, let's take a look into 15 minutes and see how they up. Yeah, 15 minutes, they would work even better. We can have this and this, the different type of stop losses. And we can take a look at the entire picture of 1 month, you know, maybe even 30 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes. Take a look, 30 minutes better. Yeah, I would say 30 minutes better. You have kind of like 1 month and a half. So yeah, you can estimate it much properly. But yeah, you know, we can have some nice trade with this. Yeah, I think, you know, yeah, I think I can make this type of predictions, you know, like for manual trade and from them as well. If them are signals. So yeah, this one can work as well. Then like I said, we have the bots, so well, let's see how it goes. I have to organize a little bit better, you know, like make some sort of document in order to take the trades and to take the accuracy, you know, of the trades. And yeah, we'll see. Slowly we're getting there. So yeah, if you guys have any question, I will stay for a bit if you have any question. Otherwise, let's see, big. Like big start to climb or what? Yeah, I didn't total. Yeah. Anyway. Tomorrow we shall see. can take some other factors into account, like for example volume. I can put the volume here as well. Yeah, something like this. You can help me. And put on it. No. And other indicator. I mean, just a simple moving average. So disgusting. Yeah, I will make myself one. I will see. But yeah, for now I will leave it here. The manual trades that we suggested, and we will see tomorrow. You know how they perform. Later on, I'm going to get back with some educational material, if I can during the day. Otherwise, the next following day. So yeah. I would like to thank you all for watching, and don't forget to follow, and in the comments, well, in the comments, in the description, you can find all the information about myself. So yeah, have a nice day.